I skip that. Yay! Ay. Alright, now let's check. If it didn't save the lives, then it's just not bother. No, it didn't. Okay. Alright, we can go back.
Game over.
Yep. Shame we have to keep seeing this thing, though. Alright. Okay, now we go to Baby. I don't know for a lot of the... What is it? I don't know a lot of, like, the different, like, specifics for each of the... Each of the monkeys, yeah, that sounds like bad grammar, but... I don't know. You know what I mean. Like, each of the characters... Wow. But no, it's like... I don't know which ones specifically are faster or all that. The only thing I know is that Baby's ball is smaller. jokes. All the jokes. But no, seriously, like... The only one I know for certain is... Well, two things. Baby's ball being smaller, and the other female monkey having a faster jump, because that's the monkey that the guy at AGDQ used, and the jumping tricks he did were freaking insane, man. Like, it's ridiculous. So... I do like my snow levels, though. Despite what people say, I do like snow levels. And it looks so nice. Visually, the game's okay, but it's nothing groundbreaking. But, you know, it's decent. It gets the job done fine, so I can't complain, really. But it's really nothing amazing or anything. Like... Games like Galaxy, of course, just look so much better. But, you know, that goes without saying. Well, even games by Sega look a lot better than this, really. Not to say that this game looks bad, per se, but... Just... Yeah. Compared to other games on the system, it just doesn't look the best. More like... It looks more like a GameCube game, in all honesty. But, you know, GameCube games did look good, so I'm not complaining too much, but it kind of goes into the whole stereotype of Wii is GameCube 2.0 and all that crap, which is kind of true to an extent, but I don't know. I just don't like how, No. I just don't like how, That kind of puts like a bad image on the Wii, in a sense. I don't know. Alright. Alright, well, let's see what happens. Oh, okay, we have another life. Can't control this. I don't think there are any ice physics though, which is nice. Alright. Okay. Oh, okay, I can continue. Okay, so it's not too bad. It's probably gonna mess up my score like no one. Yeah, zero. But honestly, I don't care. I just wanna win. Seriously, man. This is why I'd prefer just using a controller, to be honest. Like, I like the illusion of that's you yourself actually tilting the stage around. Like, of course you did that with the controller, but I guess they wanted to make go for a more real feeling and experience or whatever, which I guess works, but it's just kind of finicky. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but motion controls are kind of just a gamble in general. So I don't hate motion controls. Just to put that out there. I love Skyward Sword, just for reference, so that has to tell you something. But sometimes the motion controls just make a game worse, to be honest. Like Free Riders, this game, honestly, like if this was a controller, I'd have a lot more. I'd be able to get through this with a lot less struggling. But yeah. It's not the end of the world, but I think it just could have done better without it, honestly. At least it gives you these bonus stages so you can get some lives back up. Yeah. I honestly don't care that much about score, to be honest. I just don't care about my score in games anymore. I just want to have fun, honestly. Like, having a good score is nice, I guess, but it's just kind of come to a point where it just doesn't matter that much. Like, it's just like, oh, okay, I got a good score. Whoop-de-doo. I only really care about it in, like, Sonic games when there's a rank involved. Other than that, I don't really care that much. Wait, I guess it just kind of depends on the game as well. Because there are some games where I still get a kick out of getting as many points as possible because of the type of genre, or like just the game in general. And this, it doesn't help that it's like kind of a pit. So why is it going? I don't know why it does this. Like, I'm tilting to the right. Sometimes it goes to the left, and other times it goes to the opposite way. I don't understand that. Oh, whatever. Jump. No! I messed up. Okay. Thank you, jump. Alright. No. Okay. Slow down, please. Alright. That was a bit insane. Alright. From the looks of things, I'm just gonna tilt down. Just hope for the best. And that was not the best. A series that Jory really wants me to play. Jeez. Alright. Nope, that would have been stupid. Alright. No. Okay. Whoa. Okay. No! I almost had that. Dang it, man. Don't do this to me. Alright. Let's do this. Yo, no. Okay. Try this again. Jump again. No. Copyright strike. Alright. Those nice little snowy trees. It's not Christmas, but hey. Then again, they aren't really festive looking. They're just kind of random snowy trees. Alright, let's go. Oh my gosh. Alright, that was more my fault, but that was pretty funny. Okay. Don't do that, please. Whoa! Alright. Okay. Let's slow. Try and slow down here. Oh, it's because of that bomb. I'm just worried about some of the later levels because, you know, I haven't seen past World 5, I think, so... Bruh. Yeah, I'm kind of worried. Yeah. But we'll see what happens. No! Bruh. I'm just happy that the stages aren't lengthy or anything. Like, they're pretty short, all things considered, so I don't have to worry too much. Oh, okay, those things are the ones that shoot out the snowballs. I was wondering if they were gonna, like, fall down and try and crush me. That's why I kind of rushed. Alright. Okay. Yo, go down a little slide. This one's a lot small. Ah! Okay. That was like, that was really cartoony, like, when he was, like, rolling that fast. It looked like, a cartoon when someone's, like, kind of flat and just rolling around, like... I don't know how to explain it. Maybe I can, like, put a gif or something here showing what I mean, but it kind of reminds me of that, where just, like, really cartoony, someone's, like, rolling around and all, like, flattened and stuff. I don't know, it just kind of looked like that to me. Alright. Okay. They give you a decent amount of time, for what the level is, so... Most of the time! Oh gosh. Oh jeez. Yay! Alright. What's this? Oh, this guy, okay. Yeah, I love how obvious they make it as well. Jeez. Alright. So let's do this. Nope. It's gonna be awkward like this. Oh man, this is so ridiculous. Nope. Get away from me, you fat piece of crap. Come on, get him. There we go. Can we get him again? Nope. Alright, just repeat it, I guess. Yeah, what'd you expect me to say about this guy? Like, I don't really have a lot to say about the bosses. They kind of just speak them for themselves, to be honest. Can I just... Damn it. Yeah. So I saw the speedrunner guy hit him more than once, but I don't know how you do that. Then again, speedrunners do a lot of things that I don't know how to do. Because they are crazy suckers. Because they learn the stuff inside and out, and I don't really have the patience or time to do that, really. But there we go. Another golden banana. Baby's happy. World clear. Alright. Skip that. Nope. Okay, now we go back. Okay, gong gong. Okay, so... this, oh my gosh, I hate this so much. Alright, so it's World 4. Alright, now this is where I believe the difficulty starts ramping itself up a little bit more.
Ready? Go!
Alright. And by... oh gosh! Ramping it up, I mainly mean making areas more narrow. But beside that, it's not too different from what we've already been doing. But then again, World 4 is like the halfway point of the... well, World 5 would be halfway, but... this is pretty much like where it kind of starts to become a bit more precise, I guess? And just a lot less forgiving with mistakes, so you gotta be a lot more careful here, because, you know, I'm just worried about what's gonna come next, because, you know, I haven't even beaten World 5, I believe, so this will definitely be interesting for me, so, see how things turn out, I guess. That door, okay, I need to stop doing that, because I keep thinking it's gonna open. I get, oh gosh. I guess in a sense. Wait, whoa. Oh, he has a really bad jump. Like, I don't think it's as high as the others. Feels like it slows you down a little bit, actually. Yeah, not as many guardrails either, so. Alright, I need to stop being careless now. Those steps as well. Jeez. Nope. All right. So keep it nice and steady, but I don't want to go too slow, because otherwise, okay. Because otherwise, I will just end up gaming over or whatever. Okay. Well, just jump up steps. A worst nightmare. A monkey's worst nightmare. Steps. Come on. Yeah, this is not really designed well for the... well, maybe it's for just because Gongon's jump kind of sucks, but... yeah. Oh gosh. And can I go through? I mean, certain characters can. No. Okay. It's... I think it's Baby and the other female character. But there are so many bananas in there. It's ridiculous. Unfortunately, we can't get them. And that sucks. I absolutely failed that level. Alright. If I do this right... yo! Okay, that was kind of get a little bit close. Almost fell. Alright. Making our way through. Pretty fast, actually. Yeah, I didn't expect this game. I didn't really expect this game to last that long, honestly, because worlds go by quick. Monkey Ball, as far as I'm aware, the games don't last that long. So yeah, I wasn't really expecting this game to take very long to record. And we're almost getting to the halfway point already, and it's not even been like, I don't know, how long has it been? I'll check in a second, but oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, power time! But yeah, look at this. It hasn't even been 45 minutes. And we're already getting to the halfway point. Oh my gosh, please. Don't do this to me, game. Maybe I should stop trying to go through. It's big. Oh my gosh. Okay, I don't want to sound like I'm making up excuses, but this guy's jump just sucks. So bad. I'm also kind of failing as well, but still. Honestly, I'm just gonna. Actually, no, it doesn't even matter if I kill myself or not. Because I had to start from the beginning regardless. Okay. Oh my gosh. Alright. Let's actually do this. Okay. You know why you. I really don't like how they to put enemies in here, because I don't know, man. I think they're an unnecessary nuisance. I think, like, the obstacles put into the levels themselves are enough. But I don't like that you have to deal with enemies as well. And this is getting really obnoxious right now. Okay. Yeah, this is what. Again, if it was a controller, it would be a lot more manageable than this. But that's just me. I guess. What? Not really. A lot of people would probably say the same. Because you can do it. You can be a lot more. You'll always be a lot more precise with your actions with a controller than with motion controls. Like. I get that motion controls that you feel more like the actual character, and like, whatchamacallit. If it's done well, you can do potentially more than you could with a controller like Skyward Sword, but in terms of like accuracy and all that, you're always gonna have more with a controller, I'd say. Like, just, how do I explain this well? It's like, you're never gonna have to worry about calibrating it or have it worrying about the controller messing up unless it's like complete broken, but that's something else. But what is it? With motion controls, it's pretty much a gamble if it's gonna be if it's gonna work or not. Like, if it doesn't work and it bugs out or it keeps getting like a bad connection to the system or something like that, there's not a lot you can do to really stop it from controlling badly. But when it's like just a regular controller, you don't really have to worry about that stuff. At least for the most part, there's like other stuff to it, obviously. Like if your controller's wireless, then I guess there might be some other things you might need to worry about, but it's nothing to the extent of motion controls, where it's more of a gamble if it works or not. It's more, most of the time it's more on the game whether it works. It's not really down to the controller, unless it's like Kinect, then it kind of is, because like that's your whole body and it's a lot more intense, I guess, for lack of a better word, than the Wii Remote. But it just didn't really go well. Like, I kind of like the idea of the Kinect, like what they were trying to go for with it, but oh man, it just didn't work out. No, I like the idea of like using your full body to control a game, I guess. Like, you are doing exactly what that guy's doing or whatever. But, the execution was just horrible, really. And you can't and I don't know, I guess developers just didn't really know how to do it well. But, Connect just failed. That's pretty much the end of the story. I don't really know where I was going with that. But, yeah. Because I like motion controls when they work, but, you know, if a developer doesn't take the time to fine-tune them on and make sure they work in context with the game, it just becomes more of a nuisance than anything. And I'm not saying that this game is, like, terrible because of the motion controls. I'm still having fun. It's just the fact that if it did just use a controller, well, it just, the nunchuck or just something, GameCube controller compatibility or anything like that, to make it optional, I think it would have been a much better game overall. Especially when considering the mini games and all that I talked about earlier. But, yeah. Alright, coming to the end of World 4. Okay, I'm done. I'm just gonna go straight through the middle, to be honest. Whee! Yeah, I'm probably not gonna do that many Daredevil stunts, and this is the long boss I was talking about earlier. Basically, yeah, you have to go all the way to the end of this little machine thing, and you're all the way back here. So, yeah, this barrier goes up, and you have to hit that guy. Yeah, and it's just kind of annoying. Okay, cool. A lot of bananas. You know, actually, no, there's no point in worrying about it because it's the boss, and we lose all our lives when we go to the next world anyway. All right. I kind of like the idea of this though. Like, we're doing the missile thing, which is something that the last boss taught. Well, actually, no, it's the second boss. That was close. Alright. So, I do like they were introducing a mechanic with the missiles, and they're reusing it in the next boss for a challenge, and just kind of making it so the things you learn all matter in some way. Why are you clapping? Yeah, I'm getting hit. Clapping time. Oh my gosh. I don't know what's going on right now, to be honest. Alright, whatever. Alright. Now, I'm just gonna try cheesing this guy, because I don't even care. You saw why? You kind of saw what was going on here. But basically, if I don't fall like a moron. Yeah. Ready? Go. Alright. Basically, just gonna ignore him. Just gonna go around and hope they don't hit me. Nope. Whoa, slow down there, but God. No. Nope. Okay. Ah! Okay. Oh. Wait. Okay. Okay. No. What the hell? I was gonna say, what was that about? Alright. Let's try that again. Yeah, you get the idea. It would help if you didn't do that. Oh my gosh.
Ready? Go!
Okay. No, no! Oh my gosh! I can't be consistent. Okay, I'm just gonna do it for real. This is wasting time. Alright. Alright. I just don't like this boss. I like the idea about around it, but like, I just, again with motion controls, and I just don't think that bosses really fit the play style of Monkey Ball. But you know, that's me. All right, I think we did it. Yay! Bucko's just kind of flowing. It just kind of looks like that. Maybe, I guess, like, the bit below is just the ball, but still, it looked kind of weird.